Hey guys, the Ancient Rebellion here, and welcome back to From the Depths. Now, I know it's been about a week since I have last played this, and that's because I'm thinking about doing some, well, things a little differently around here. Like, one week I will be doing From the Depths, the other week I'll be doing World of Tanks, and keep on switching between them. Now, don't worry, I'm not... This isn't me saying I'm going to focus more on World of Tanks than From the Depths. This is me simply switching between the two, so that it's not just all From the Depths and nothing else. So, what we're going to be doing today in From Depths is building a superstructure on the Behemoth, as I have now called it. Well, not really now called it, but as I am liking to call it. There we go. Now, I'm not quite sure how much room these turrets need, but I know it can't be a lot. Well, it can be a lot, and it probably will. So, I'm going to have to simply come round and check it. And then eventually we won't have to sit in the gun barrel of the sea turret. Now, I could have built these more into the deck, which I am partially wishing I had done, but... Oh, I don't have these overclocked. So let's just quickly go around and overclock these barrels and see how fast they will fire. Because I am starting to think. Okay. Seems a lot better, because before these were firing so infrequently. Well, not infrequently, but they were hardly firing, and that wasn't very fun. This one still needs to be clocked. So these aren't going to be well armored or anything really else, but they are going to serve the purpose of faster firing guns than the primary. Now, when these do fire, it will be at, hopefully, well, hopefully the fire will be accurate. They won't get taken out very quickly. Now, the main armament is so heavily armoured, I'm hoping that it doesn't get taken out. But if it does, then we have backups in the form of a lot of high explosive EMP, well, more high explosive EMPs, and probably a couple of missiles as well that I am probably could possibly put. Because honestly, I'm not expecting great things from these. And I think I've already cocked it up. Let's see. So that's this one. It's the one that's got space. I should go to this one. Seems like I can fill in these spaces. So now that I have that information, that means swarm missiles, because of course it does. You don't come and watch my From the Depths videos without expecting some swarm missiles, because obviously that is what I absolutely adore using. As you could probably tell. So, as I was saying, I can't actually remember. Oh yeah, as you can tell by my, well, by the Pontus and also by the, so it seems like there is a larger gap by the front, and also I forgot to put mirror mode on yet again. Right, okay. So this front one is a lot closer. Well, it has a gap. Unfortunately, I can't get these to sit flush with the deck, so there will be gaps underneath them. You can just switch between key and mouse based placing of these blocks, because otherwise that would have taken so much longer to do. Oh, that one didn't want to go there. That can go there. This one further. This other one. Hang on, have these all been messed up? These front two haven't been placed properly. Which means I'm going to have to replace them. up on this one is going to go. The local weapon control is going to have to move as well. So it goes there. That's my big turret. Yes, it is. This one's too forward again. And I forgot yet again to turn mirror mode on. Like I say, this channel is literally just going to be me forgetting mirror mode every single time. It would have made more sense to use it. But there we go. Still on? Yes, it is. And go down here. Let's turn the one block on. So, what's going to happen is missiles need the controller. I forgot to I'm going to have to turn off Mirabeau to fix that, but anyway, so we will get these small launchers all connected, small gantry. So, and small launches, small country, small country. But I actually think that everybody knows what I'm probably going to do here. Because this is a completely explosive EMP build, pretty much. It's going to suck when any of these weapons hit you. I'm also going to need to go underneath and add staggered swarm. Yep, that's connected. 0.15. Let's go back to this. And do that. And then we're going to have to do the same down here. So then what we have are even more missiles. So we've got the staggered fire, the identify friend or foe, and finally the Let's just hope it's doing the same on the other side. So if the missile controller of one of these gets taken out, it won't take out the others. So unlike the swarm mother, we are not going to lose all of our missiles if only one of them gets destroyed. Let's just load those and figure out what has gone wrong here. Let's turn off mirror mode because I don't actually understand what happened there, but missiles are in line with those. What? Okay, this side is going to need a bit of tweaking, shall we say. So now these can be fired. Are these connected up the same way? Oh god, so this thing appears to be off. Apparently this localized weapon controller didn't want to join in on the fun. Copy all. So now, so this side's going to need. And I click the wrong button. Okay, so apparently the front sides don't actually have. Okay, it is connected. This one's connected. This one's connected. Now we've just got one more, and then we can start working on this superstructure instead of just adding missiles. Now it's probably going to extend right to the back of this front turret out a bit like that. Come behind and then extend all the way to this rear turret. Now this turret should be able to fire at respectable angles. I don't need it to aim this way and shoot, as that's probably wouldn't be the best. Now all I need is for mirror mode to be turned on. In the correct space, there we go. Now I'm probably going to add a bunch of smaller secondaries as, well, obviously just these aren't going to cut it. Okay, so I'm going to need to take this back one and put those up there. Then I'm going to need the identify friend or foe, staggered fire, the controller, these small launchers, these small gantries, and finally, after a rotation. Please tell me that this missile controller. Staggered fire and identify friend or foe are working. Sort this one out. So these ones are simple enough. Let's just put it there, get rid of that, put it back again. Put that there, get rid of it, and put it back. So these are connected. Let's see if these are connected as well. Yep, so that actually did it. Now, let's see if this will go well. Let's go Marauder. Turn it off. Oh. So apparently these guns don't really work, and there goes the missiles. And I missed all of that. Uh-oh. So these missiles just... I think we need to see that one more time. Let's try against a Kalmar.
Turning off.
Kalmar got a shot off. But the Kalmar has been hit. Our main guns fire. Punching right through, and our missiles just go in and absolutely destroy. And there is still one. To test against one last ship. It's going to be a godly class Onyx watch. I haven't actually tested this ship against the Bulwark yet.
Turning off.
Oh, thank God I quickly turn the Bulwark off, because it has these missiles that are going for the wrong ship. I mean, the Bulwark's missile defenses are
engaging
pretty formidable, actually. But the main gun. Oh, no, I don't want to get rid of the ship that I just built. Let's give it time to reload. As I need to put down some material storage. So apparently when I die, I turn purple, which is an interesting thing to note. But now that we have hopefully reloaded everything, I'm sat there. Now, let's go after a bulwark. Let's see how well we can do.
Turning off.
Oh, bulwarks fired a couple of shots. And our shells have done no damage. But the swarm of missiles that are getting sent are getting annihilated. Oh dear. I want to know what the bulwark's laser defense. Okay. Is that EMP explosive? A shot should have helped. But so our little shells are hitting and not doing much, but the laser defense is still going after our missiles, which are really doing nothing. Let's quickly teleport to the bottom of the ocean, just so I can see this better without rocking wildly. So, the missiles seem to go in. We can get to here, and then they just get focused down. I'm not even sure it's going well. Let's see. Laser defense is. Oh, that was a nice bit of damage, but I need them to aim more there. Oh, now the missiles are getting through and the bulwark is still taking this damage really, really well. The EMPs don't seem to be doing much because it's got a bunch of surge protectors. So right now this seems to just be pure armor piercing. Well, explosive, because we don't actually have any armor piercing weapons yet. Now I need my main guns to fire again, please. Because when the missiles are active, too much EMPs. One of the lasers is still active. But shot, it seems like, has taken too much, and now the full volley is going to come in, as well as the main arm, and I think that's it for the bulwark. I think I'm going to have to put this delay on a little bit more, because when one hits the ship, all of the missiles seem to explode. But the bulwark can take some damage. Oh, so this is... side of the bulwark is getting messed up. I think that's the only way that I can see this. I think we need fragmentation EMP warheads. Yeah, we need fragmentation, because when these go off, fragmentation isn't what So I know fragmentation was nerfed a little bit ago, but when you have this amount of them, surely you can't go wrong with a bit of frag. That is a beautiful sight though. So the mainframe needs more processing power, so that's why these aren't as accurate as they could be. Right, not all of these are frag, but I think enough of them are so that when some of them explode, there's a nice amount of fragments flying off at the bulwark. You can just see all of the pieces. Lots just falling off of it. Fragmentation might have been nerfed, but if it's a lot of fragments. Yep, there's the fragmentation. So it seems like fragmentation EMP might actually be the right way to go. because, I mean, if one of the fragmentation actually gets through, there's a gap. Oh. Okay. So, the bulwark for a godly class ship is looking a little worse for wear. Oh, there comes my big shells. So we have now decided to position ourselves towards the front, and that's one of the turret. Well, that's the B turret getting blown off. And now that is the bulwark's heavy armour getting shredded. Wow. I'm just astounded by how much this fragmentation actually does damage wise. So, as you can probably, well, we've taken out two of the AIs, there's only one left now, which I'm guessing might actually be towards the rear of the ship. But we are, I'd say we're just cleaving our way through the ship bit by bit. And that was a bunch of missiles have just stopped. I mean, these are the main turrets that have got had a lot of heavy armour, because now it doesn't even have any front turrets. Wow. But anyway, guys, thank you so much for watching, and I'll see you in the next video.